Well, Gary, congratulations again. It's a long journey here. To come away with 3 points is obviously excellent. Give us your thoughts on the match.
Terrific performance for the players. I think in the first half again we were back to our normal selves. We started, you know, the first half against Annan. Annan were the better team, but we started really well today. Came out the traps flying, got an early goal. Could have had a couple more, and in the first half I generally thought we were quite comfortable. In the second half, you know, I thought the game was a bit more even, and as the game wore on, I think we had to defend a lot more. Stranraer changed their shape a few times. I think they made 4 or 5 subs. Most of the subs that came on were attacking people, and I actually found that they were playing a little bit more direct and looking for knockdowns and flick-throughs. So we had to change our shape a wee bit and go a wee bit more defensive than we normally do to try and combat that, and the players done that. You know, the players, when they had to defend, were excellent. And we get that clean sheet that we've been looking for, and you know, it's probably been we should have had more clean sheets than we've had, but today to get one at such a difficult venue against such a good team when we've been under a bit of pressure in the last 20 minutes is very, very pleasing for not only myself but for the players as well.
Yeah. And just going back to the first goal, I thought really, you know, Uzi instrumental in two phases of the play in terms of, you know, taking it through and then Liam Brown following it up. Josh Campbell's rattling the woodwork.
Yeah, listen, the link-up play between Josh and Uzi is pleasing. They're getting a wee partnership going there, and that's very pleasing. And, you know, we're obviously a little bit away for the goal. Stranraer thought he was maybe offside. I don't know if he was offside or not, the through ball and the cross in. So we may have got a little bit of luck there. I'll have to see it back. But Uzi then puts the ball in. Josh, unlucky, hits the bar. Liam, great, coming in for the wider area and heads it and gets his goal. And as I say, at that stage, you know, we look comfortable. I think Stranraer in the first half had 2 long-range efforts that went wide. So coming away to home against the team that you're sort of battling to get in the playoffs with, that was a very pleasing first half. But a stress to the players at half-time, you don't get anything for that. And we were a wee bit slack in the start of the set. Just little things that I don't need to go into detail, but things that we'd done well in the first half, we sort of changed for 5 or 10 minutes in the second half, and we ended up getting caught in the ball. And that invites pressure onto you, and then we sort of weathered that, and then, as I said, Stranraer made the changes, put more people forward. Even I think the big centre-half Robertson at times was going up the pitch, but the lads stood up and were counted when it mattered. And as I say, I think based on our first half performance, I think we deserve the 3 points.
Yeah, second half, I think that probably gives you more answers about character of the squad that you're now dealing with. They know what's ahead of them. We could hear that from the side of the park as well. And you've got to be pleased with that as well.
I'm delighted with them, you know, but it's what I've been trying to drum into them. You know, if you want to be a successful team, you need to try and keep more clean sheets. Very unusual for a team not to keep clean sheets and keep outscoring everybody every week. So far, we have done that, but that's an unusual statistic in football. You need clean sheets. If you look at Queen's Park, for example, in our league, I know they conceded a goal today, but their success has been based on at the back, and then they've got the talented players in front. Well, we need to get along the lines of that, because we've got as much talent as anybody in this league in the forward areas of the pitch. We need to make sure that we're not always conceding. Some games you have to win 1-0 or you have to draw 0-0. You're not always score. So the lads are aware of it. They had my frustrations. It wasn't just me. You know, they're as frustrated as me that we never managed to get a clean sheet, but today we defended well. And we got that clean sheet, and hopefully we can go and build on that now.
Yeah, one of the messages that you were speaking about again at your last interview with us was opening up that 7-point gap again. You know, that was really required, which gives you, I suppose, now the chance to look at targets for the rest of the season in terms of where we're going to be.
Well, the first thing I wanted to do when I got the job was try and get into the top four, because there's still no guarantees that the split is going to happen. So obviously people will say, well, you have to make sure you're in the top 5 if the split happens. Well, obviously that's what we wanted to do, and I think mathematically now, if the split goes ahead, we're in the top 5. So first job's done. Then in case the split doesn't go ahead, we knew that we had to make sure that we're in the top 4. So I think we're 7 points clear now with 3 games to go, so we're nearly there if the split doesn't happen. So that's how you need to work, because there's no guarantees it is going to happen. We think it's going to happen, so you just want to keep picking up points. Not really worrying about the teams that are slightly above you. You're trying to detach somebody from the group. You know, we've managed to do that a little bit with Stenhouse Muir in terms of trying to get into the top 5. You know, we've pushed Stenhouse Muir away. So well done to the players for that. And now we were Stranraer were the next team below us, we were trying to open a gap on them, and we've done that today. But if Stranraer won on Tuesday and we get beat against Brechin because we think we've came to Stranraer and won them with the bee's knees, then this one today is irrelevant. So, yes, it's nice to have a 7-point gap in the fourth place team. It doesn't mean anything. It just is a nice situation to be in that we're not the team trying to claw back a 7-point deficit.
And in terms of your first time that you met the squad, and I think that was one of the clear messages that you set out as well, over 5 points off a playoff spot. That was first and foremost, regardless of, you know, the potential split, was the games that you know that you had left, you had to get into the playoffs.
I told them that we had to work on that we had 9 games left. And as it stood, it was a 9-game season, and if you want, we were starting on -5. Mm-hmm. We were 5 points outside the playoffs. So for the players to now be 7 points clear of the fifth place team, shows how well we've done since we came in. Listen, I got an award, and you know, I spoke to the players about that, and I thanked them. It's nothing to do with me. It's the level of fitness, as I said in the interview that I done when I got the award, how they've looked after themselves, the fitness that they've done when they're away, and then they've came back, and even in the games now, you know, we're not tiring, which shows that they've looked after themselves, which shows that James gave them the right programme to do when he was the manager and when they were in the lockdown, and it shows that they're good professionals. So the credit has to go to them. I've took them 5 training sessions or something. So you get a minimal stuff. What's happened is they've got a bounce for a new manager coming in. Most times people do. What we've managed to do is get the bounce and then continue it. And I want to continue it to the end of the season. I never ever want their standards to slip because they've shown me what they're capable of. So that was the talk to them at the start. The very first night I met them, I think you listened to the talk I gave to them. In fact, I think it wasn't the first night, it was when the chairman found out what was going to happen. I think it was the first Saturday we'd done. And I said to them, simplify it. Forget the split. If the split doesn't happen, you've only got 9 games. You're 5 points behind the playoffs. We need to try and make that up. Mm-hmm. And so far, we've done a good job of making that up and better. But we're not going to let our standards drop. You know, Brechin, yes, OK, they're bottom of the league. You didn't always beat the teams that are at the bottom of the league. Look, if you look at Annan, for example, I think they were third or fourth bottom. We had a very difficult first half against Annan. And they gave us as difficult a game as anybody has since I've taken over. So I'm expecting that with Brechin. Brechin are fighting for their life. There's no really point in them coming to try and set up and get a point. Yep. They need 3 points. Yep. So they're going to have to come and attack us. So we need to be prepared for that. But on the same thing, I'd like to think we can carry our momentum forward and go and try and take another 3 points, which would really cement yourself in the top mm-hmm. four. But if we don't apply ourselves the way that we've applied ourselves in the previous 5 games and our 6 games in the league, then we'll get beat. Simple football, simple. You've got to do the hard work first. If you didn't do the hard work, ability is nothing. You've got to do the hard work, be organised, listen to the instructions for the management team, which they're doing. And then their ability will always see them through because they're a talented group of players.
And you've managed to navigate yourself away from talking about the manager of the month. Congratulations. And also, I guess, you know, it's always the curse of the manager of the month award where the following Saturday you've got to get out there and you've got to continue your job.
Well, the last time I got a manager of the month, I lost my job 3 months later, so I didn't really want another one. Manager of the month at the end of January at Queen of the South, and I was out the door at the start of May. Yeah. So, but no, listen, as I say, it's nice to get awards, but honestly, anybody that knows me, it's not about me. It's never has been. I don't really like speaking about the past, but even when, you know, we had success at East Fife, I got more joy for watching the volunteers and the people that work for nothing and yeah. Leona in the office and the chairman that. I get my joy for the chairman and that being happy that their team are winning on the pitch mm-hmm. and that. For me, yeah, it's nice to get awards, but honestly, they're in a box or that somewhere. It's not. I've never been like that. Even my medals that I've won in my career or that, I'd have to go and look for them. It's not. It isn't about that for me. It's about just doing my job. If we get rewarded with accolades, we know. But I know when I'm doing something right and I know when I've done something wrong. I got something wrong against Annan and I informed the players that at the training. You know, so you have to always judge yourself first. And just now, because of the players, the backroom staff and myself are getting a lot of accolades, it's nothing to do with us. It's because of the players. It's simple, honestly. People say, everybody says, it is. I've only took them for 5 training sessions. How can it be anything to do with me?
Well, I hope you, your backroom staff, the squad, you know, you're enjoying your moment in the sun, quite literally, as we're speaking just now. So, again, we'll say upwards and onwards, and we'll see you on Tuesday night again.
Cheers, Callum. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Gary.